Namaste. In this clipping, I am trying to explain to you the equi-marginal utility consumer equilibrium theory. Over here, in the earlier video, I have explained to you that the marginal utility of the product X should be equated to the marginal utility of the product Y. Right? Or in other words, marginal utility derived from X commodity should be equal to marginal utility derived from Y commodity for the consumer to attain equilibrium. Right? Now, this is the simplest condition for consumer equilibrium when the assumption about price is made in this way. Price of X commodity is equal to Y commodity is equal to 1, right? Only when price of X commodity is equal to the price of Y commodity and that is equal to 1, then this is the most simplest way in which the consumer equilibrium to commodity case can be expressed. Now, what if the price of X and price of Y are not equal? In such a case, the ratio of marginal utility of product X to the price of the product should be equal to the marginal utility of product Y to the ratio of the price of the product, right? Now, let us take up an example wherein the prices of the two commodities, let's say Px is 4 and Py is 2. Okay? And then the marginal utility of X is given as 4 and the marginal utility of Y is given as 8. Okay? So in this case, if you are going to use this information, 4 divided by price of X is 4, marginal utility of X is given as 4 with, okay, that's what I've substituted here. Price of X is 4 divided by 4. Fine. And on the other side, marginal utility of product Y is 8. And then price of Y is 2. Right. So in this case, this will become 1 and this will become 4. So very clearly, because of consuming, marginal utility of Y divided by price of Y, that is what I have brought in here, which shows by consuming Y, the consumer is gaining more satisfaction compared to when he is going to consume X. Right? So, let me rewrite it. Marginal utility to the price of X is lesser than marginal utility of Y to the price of Y. Yeah, so this is what is the given situation that we have arrived at. Fine, given the example. So in this case, Y is going to be most satisfying for the consumer. So the consumer will increase the consumption of Y. So even as the consumption of Y is going to increase, there is going to be the diminishing marginal utility in operation, and the marginal utility derived from Y is going to fall. Right? And you know that given the income and given the prices of the commodities, that is when the income does not change and when the price does not change, fine, to buy more of Y, necessarily the consumer has to give up on the other. Fine. only if the consumer is going to sacrifice X, then he will be able to have more of Y. So when the consumer is having more of Y, there will be a diminishing marginal utility in the case of Y. And this increase in Y is possible because X is sacrificed or units of X are reduced. So in the case of X, there will be an increasing marginal utility. So you see that, see what was the problem? In the case of X, there was lesser satisfaction. In the case of Y, there was more satisfaction. That's why the consumer consumes more of Y, right? And if he wants to increase more, that is have more of Y, then that will be possible only when he gives up X. So as consumption of Y increases, there will be diminishing marginal utility in the case of Y. And as the consumer reduces the consumption of X, there will be increasing marginal utility in the case of X. So this chain reaction will keep happening. Till when? Till the marginal utility of both the products are going to be same. Right? So eventually there will be equality attained between the two marginal utilities, and that is where the consumer will stop the expenditure pattern or will attain the equilibrium. So in case there is going to be a disequilibrium like this, where marginal utility of Y is going to be more than the marginal utility of X, then there will be increased consumption of Y that will reduce the marginal utility derived from Y. And on the other hand, in the case of X, since units of X are going to be used lesser and lesser, there will be increasing marginal utility in the case of X. So ultimately, fall in this and increase in this will result in IMU and DMU, and that juggling will take the consumer back to the marginal utility of X commodity being equal to marginal utility of Y commodity, right? So that is why this is the only possible equilibrium in the two commodity case. Similarly, you can imagine what happens when the marginal utility of X to the price of X ratio of these two is going to be more than that of the marginal utility of Y to the price of Y. In this case, X is more satisfying. So consumption of X will increase, which will lead to diminishing marginal utility in the case of X. And more of X can be had only when Y commodity is going to be reduced. That is, less of Y is going to be consumed. So in that case, there will be increasing marginal utility. So once more, there will be juggling here, right? So this is a disequilibrium, right? So there will be change in consumption pattern or a chain equation happening. So this will keep happening. The increasing and the diminishing marginal utility will keep happening because of the substitution that's happening there. So ultimately, once more, the marginal utility of the two products will become equal. So that is when the consumer would not like to change his expenditure pattern. So this equation of marginal utility will be the condition for consumer equilibrium, or this is exactly where the consumer attains equilibrium when there is an equality of the marginal utilities of the two commodities, right? Okay, hope you have understood that with the ordinal theory. Probably I'll explain the ordinal theory in my next clipping. Thank you.